Okay, so let's talk about dividing whole numbers and their applications. You can show division in several different ways. These are three of the most common ways to show division. My favorite way, once we get up into the higher levels of math, is going to be the fraction bar. Fraction bars mean division. So 12 divided by 4 can also be written as 12 divided by 4. So those are the same thing. They have the same meaning. This is an important concept right here. Any number divided by itself is 1. So 5 divided by 5 is 1. Also, any number divided by 1 is itself. So 17 divided by 1 is 17. Those are important things for you to remember as we move on through this lesson. 0 divided by any number is 0. But if you turn that around, if you write it as 4 divided by 0, that is undefined. You are not allowed to ever divide by 0. Ever. So anytime you have 0 in the denominator, your answer should always be, I do not know what just happened there. Okay, so the division properties of 0 are pretty important too. You are allowed to divide 0 by any number. Doesn't matter what the number is, 0 divided by 4 in this case is 0. However, if you flip that around and you do 4 divided by 0, you have to say undefined. You are never, ever, ever allowed to divide by 0. That is bad. So your answer would always be, if 0 is in the denominator, you would say undefined. Okay, so let's say in this problem we want to divide 1,439 by 4. So 1,439 by 4. 4 will not go into 1, so I'm not going to put a number above the 1, but 4 will go into 14. It'll go in there 3 times. 3 times 4 is 12. You subtract. 14 minus 12 is 2. Bring down your 3 here. 4 will go into 23 5 times. 5 times 4 is 20. Subtract. 23 minus 20 is 3. Bring down your 9. 4 will go into 39 9 times. 9 times 4 is 36. Subtract and you're left with 3. So how you would write this remainder is like that, or you could write it as 359 and 3/4. Where did I get this 4 from? It came from right here. This 3, that is our remainder, came from right there. Okay? So how you would check this. So let's say that I want to check my work. I would do 359 times 4. And I would see that I get something close to 1,439. It won't quite be 1,439 until I add in my remainder. So let's do 4 times 9 is 36. 4 times 5 is 20. Plus 3 is 23. 4 times 3 is 12. Plus 2 is 14. Then you have to add in your remainder. And you should get the number that you started out with. And we did. So we do know that this right here is the correct answer. There's several ways that you can say division. You can say divided by, you can say quotient of, or the quotient of 12 and 4, or 4 divided into 12. Now you have to be careful with that last one because that implies that you have to reverse the order. 4 divided into 12 really means 12 divided by 4. So be really careful with that. Okay, Cecilia bought a 160-ounce box of oatmeal at the big box store. She wants to divide 160 ounces of the oatmeal into 8-ounce servings. She will put each serving into a plastic bag so she can take one bag to work each day. How many servings will she get from that box? So she wants 8-ounce servings in each baggie. So that would be 160 divided by 8. 8 won't go into 1, but it will go into 16 twice. 2 times 8 is 16. You subtract and you get 0. Bring down that 0. 8 will go into 0. 0 times. So what does 20 mean? 20 is our answer, but what does it mean in this situation? It is how many servings she will get. So you need to always label your final answer. So 20 servings. Marcus is setting out animal crackers for snacks at the preschool. He wants to put 9 crackers in each cup. One box of animal crackers has 135 crackers. How many cups can he fill from one box of crackers? Well, in this case, we would do 135 divided by 9. 9 won't go into 1, but it will go into 13 one time. 1 times 9 is 9. Subtract. 13 minus 9 is 4. Bring down that 5. 9 will go into 45 5 times. So our answer is 15 with no remainder. But what does 15 mean? It says right here, how many cups? Always look back at your question, how many cups? So he can fill 15 cups. Andrea is making bows for the girls in her dance class to wear at the recital. Each bow takes 4 feet of ribbon, and 36 feet of ribbon are on one spool. How many bows can Andrea make from one spool of ribbon? In this case, she has 36 total feet on one spool. She's going to use 4 feet for one bow. 4 will go into 36 9 times. And what 9 means in this situation is, how many bows can Andrea make from one spool? She can make 9 bows from one spool, provided she doesn't mess up at all.